Welcome back from that commercial break. You are still watching Saloon Talk. We're always here every Sunday from 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. We are at Spectra Saloon, and these guys have the best hair services, face services, literally everything that you want to be done, they have it right here. We were talking about relationships, and now we're going to jump right into the issues that are facing, that people are facing in relationships and how to solve them. Let me start with the man himself, Fred Owens. First, tell us, I know you've been in a relationship before. There is a relationship that you were with, a very long-lasting relationship. First, tell us, what are some of the issues that you have faced in the longest relationship you've ever had?
The first issue is when not to let go, when you feel it's wrong. Like, people never face up. Like, I'll be here, I'm biased about you, I'm tired about you, but I don't want to let go. Because I want maybe to see you happy or something like that. Like, it's both ways, it's with both genders. It's a very ongoing issue. So situation, entanglement, whatever. You'll be having triangles, octagons, and you'll be sleeping around with so many people, but you don't want to go, and it becomes toxic. So I feel like that is eating up so many situations.
So, like, when you found yourself in that situation, what was the solution that you came up with? Yes, you said like it's very hard to let go, but at a point, one of you has to man up, or one of you has to face up what is going on. So what solution did you actually come up with in that situation?
Well, one thing everyone fears is a breakup. You know,
true.
Whether it's you have done wrong or not, everyone, if you have truly have been in love with that person, everyone fears breakup because of the memories.
I feel like I can't wait for him to break up with me. I'm tired.
That wasn't a love then.
Okay. All right, Daddy Andre. You are in a serious relationship.
Actually, I didn't finish my point.
You are at a serious relationship at a point. Sorry, Pastor. Yeah. Sorry.
I don't know about it. But anyways, the thing is, the solution you said to that issue is learning how to close the perfect view of the window. And you know that, okay, this view is perfect. I feel like I should be here every time, but I have to close it and move on. Right? You have to learn to let go. Oh, which is hard, but you have to face up. And
how long did it take you to actually become the person that you were before you met this person? Because obviously, after a breakup, every person, whether you're a man, whether you're a woman, we all deal with our issues in a different way. Some people go to bars, others just
trust me, if after a breakup you don't go to the person, you were after meeting or before meeting the person.
So you become a better or worse?
Either you become the worst or the better, because you have learned some new traits, characters from this person. So it's either you go better or you go worse. Okay, so I believe you don't stay the same person before. No, you go to a new version of yourself. That's how they call it, a breakdown. Then you heal. You know, exactly. It's either that new person you are going to break or love. Sure, you know, yeah.
So, big man, I know you've been waiting for me to ask you, but okay, let me come now. You are in a serious relationship with one of your fellow artists, Nina Rose, and it didn't end well, as everybody expected. She came out in an interview and was like, the relationship that you guys had was never good from the beginning. And we are wondering, because the love that was between you guys was seen. It was seen by everybody. You people worked together. So what's going on? What happened? For you, what happened? What are the issues that separated you guys?
Of course, her perspective was like, from the beginning, the love was not okay.
That's what she said.
She would have decided at the beginning. Seriously. Okay, so if she doesn't love God, then that's bad. If something was bad at the beginning for her, I did know.
Exactly.
So meaning it was her own trap. She trapped herself. Because for me, I know a relationship, there's always having decision making. And if you decide to go into something that you are into, that's a covenant or an agreement or a contract, but within hearts, of course. Now I'm into your body. Nah, I know you like it. So, I'm also human.
Of course.
Yes, so the decision making she made, I think it's the way how she cast herself. Because me, I didn't know. Now I've known. And I'm really sorry for her, maybe she wasn't ready for love, and that's the reason why maybe she jumped out. Because me, I was seeing everything okay, even up to now, I still see it as okay. Because I know relationship, when you're ready for relationship, you're always having those disasters, you know, ups and downs, you know, yeah. And a person that you always fall for, there's something that you will always get to, like those problems, those small things. You can sometimes give time to yourself. We have what we call giving time, then we have what we call breaking up, and then we have what we call like it has refused. So I don't know if the time that, if maybe that time, me, I thought it was relationship, and maybe towards her side it was a dating, maybe. And why was she
time.
And why was she hurt if it was dating? So I don't know, maybe it's quite confusing. Now I'm lost about
actually,
the statements.
It's actually very confusing.
People,
because,
people
yeah,
be
and me, I'm okay. And me, I'm okay. Like even up point. To now, up to now, like he said, you never hate someone that you
exactly.
you once loved.
Love, yeah.
And for me, I'm still in love.
I want to. To so quick do some cartoon because I'm gonna come back to you and you're gonna tell us. Everybody here is gonna tell us.
Okay.
One solution.
Yeah,
to an issue, like a solution to an issue, like what you think we can do better. And being a girl, you're gonna tell the men what they can do to make a relationship stronger. And you guys are gonna tell us what women can do. So let us have a big man himself. So you've been in a relationship before, I'm very sure, right? You have been in a long-term relationship with someone. What are some of those issues that you look at and you're like, oh God, if she didn't do that, we would be in a very good place?
I think let's look at it from a broad spectrum where, well, I think one of the issues with relationships, let's be straight with it, okay? Communication, sex.
Yeah, true, yeah.
Do you understand?
Let's
be
straight.
Do you understand? One of the leading cause of divorce in marriages is sex. And people tend not to understand this. When you communicate, I lack communication as an individual. Do you understand? And I agree. Do you understand? I see my fault and I know it. Now, when you, when I talk about sex, not from me, but understand that it gets to a time in a relationship where you're with someone. And the sex is no longer fantastic. It's no longer as it should be. No, understand
yeah, it's,
this.
It's,
it happens.
It's no longer romantic.
You understand. And there are ways to fix all of this. But there's another thing that we tend to do. We tend to jump out. We tend to feel like we're not in love. And when people find that they are not attractive with the person, they feel like they're not in love anymore with the person and they want to get out as soon as possible. That this love is no longer there. It boils down to sex, you understand? Even in homes, you understand? Now, understanding that fact, sex in a relationship is 10%.
Yeah,
understand,
true.
No, understand the trick. Sex in a relationship is 10%. But the moment you take that sex 10% out of the relationship, you've taken 90% out of it. And most of these things are traits from the past. People tend to bring that in their relationship, not because they've started now, but because when we talk about this psychology with women, when I talk with a lot of married people, and we determine their issues with their relationship, we don't end there. I try to take it back to how they were raised, what has happened to them,
yeah.
their previous relationship. Some women are just, you see, when some women do not trust anybody, they've been through a lot. So, but they are by default defensive with whatever you say.
Yeah.
You understand?
They use excuses.
Yeah, they use excuses. And the man feels offended and feels like she's being bossy. Like, you chill, I'm the man. I should tell you what, I should like, no, don't tell me what to do. You understand? It's not her fault also. It's coming from a place of pain, hurt, and trying to match her guard as an individual.
You talked about the 10% that comes from the 100. If you take away the 10% that is the sex from the 100, it automatically also takes away the 90. On the 100%, let us get to understand this. If sex is 10%, love is, let me give you like 30%, like care, words. Even arguments are part of a relationship. They're also part of the 10%. Yes, so most people, actually, on top of what you said, of women having background issues, childhood issues, traumas, also men.
Yes,
we have to understand this, by the way. We have to understand, because most people do not, everybody makes excuses. The men makes they make excuses for themselves that, oh, I've been through this. And it's actually, it's very more hectic if the guy is a little bit older than the girl. It is very hectic because why? Let me first finish my point. what I'm trying to say is that you said women have to play the role of women. We do not have to act bossy, show that we are bossy. But a relationship is a two-way street. Not only financially, but also emotionally, psychologically, and mentally, everything. But most men, most like I gave an example of, if the man is older than you, and you have, and he, because being older than you, that means he has been through ages that you are not yet here in the world. That means he has seen things that you haven't yet seen. But if we are to be in this generation right now, very many girls, very many people, even men, very many people these days have grown up when they have been taught to hustle from a young age. They have fended for themselves, yet they have families. So the perspective that we have now is not the perspective of people had then. So what I'm trying to say is that men expect us to be the woman version, like the woman type, like the women in the relationship. But we need to be emotionally supported too. If let me say a man, now like how you said about your character, you are not a person who talks, a person who communicates. If let me say your girlfriend had an issue that you had done and she comes and approaches to you, I'm very sure you would like first keep quiet. You would not say anything.
No, that's not what I mean with my communication. I'm an impromptu person. So I can be like, you know what? Let's go to this place, and I will not tell her, and I'll just go. And normally in communication with women, you have to understand that they are emotionally attached to you. So when he calls me, I'm like, bro, come, let's go to this place. I don't just pick my phone and start calling my girlfriend. You know what? Andreas called me that we should go to this place. I don't. I might go and come back and tell her, I went to this place with Andre. And she's like, why didn't you say? You understand? I'm very poor at that. And that is not because I do it by default. Now, when I was younger, I used to go to school. It was very far back home. And because of the polygamous home and all of that, so I tend to want to always keep things to myself by default because of what I've seen. Now I'm talking about background. So it followed me to now, to this time, to be like, okay, you know what? When I want to do anything, when I want to go anywhere, I don't say. My mom would just see me coming back from school and I'm home. I don't tell her when I'm leaving. I don't tell her when I'm coming back because I'm trying to like, okay, not to say too much so that everybody does know. So now it has followed me into my relationship.
We are running out of time, but let us go to a short commercial break. When we come back, everybody here is going to tell us a solution to an issue that relationships are facing right about now. You're still watching Saloon Talk. I'm your girl, Savaria Hughes, and we are still at Spectra Saloon. Yes, welcome back from that commercial break. You are still watching Saloon Talk. And if you've been following the show right about from the start, guys, it has been a hell of a conversation. For all of you who are out there, what did you mean? You're thinking, please settle down, relax. We are going to give you some of the solutions that you have to look into your relationship and see. What is missing? What is going on? What am I seeing? The red flags, am I ignoring them or am I actually, you know, letting them be, or like, am I tolerating them? So my guests, my beautiful guests, are gonna tell us their solutions to a specific problem that are affecting the relationships. We are still at Spectra Saloon. Don't forget to go down to our social media platforms and also tell us your opinion of what spoils a relationship. Let us start from Rasta.
First, I talked about sex and I talked about communication. And when we put the two words together, it boils down to one thing. If the sex is not great as it used to be before, it does not mean you're still not in love. You learn to talk about it. You learn to find solutions on how to tackle such issues. It does not mean you're still not attractive or attracting to the person that you're with. Then that now links to communication. So you understand, to be able to tell your partner, okay, I'm doing this, I'm doing that, I'm going here, I'm going there, you understand? And also, there are some things you should learn to do is let go of issues. Women know how to hold on to quarrels for too long, you understand, an argument for too long. Arguing does not mean you're breaking up. Sex is not good does not mean you're breaking up. All you need to do, one thing, is to communicate. Okay, I think I have this and I don't like it about you. Can we change it? And the truth is, do not expect anyone you've said once or twice to change immediately.
True, yeah.
Do you understand? It takes work. It takes time. It can take a year for a person to change. And the one thing I know about change is that sometimes as a woman, when you change your attitude towards how the man perceives you, the man automatically by default starts to change. That's it. Thank you.
Wow. Okay. Stubborn. What is the solution to according to your personal life? Because you've been through a lot, by the way, and we are very sorry for that. I'm just, can't I crack a joke?
I know, I'm no, entire, but you're right.
I'm entire joking.
No, you're right.
Yeah.
We all go through. So, for me, what I know, I won't talk too much. I'm always advising people to go look out for God. Find wisdom. Accept the default and how you've grown up. Know yourself. Find out the manners, behaviors, character, charity, ways, and integrity from the person. All those demands before you go to anything. So I think balance, and you have to know that these people are not perfect, they're humans as well, and you have to know that people as well have different traditions, cultures. Abamu basezi, abamu bali traumatized, abamu bali depressed, others
and others Noah.
Yes, so sometimes and others who decide to leave their fellows. Sometimes they also as well have own problems that they don't want to accept. So we have to fight the living in denial, and then we have to accept that God is the solution to everything. Me, I'll always go around, but the truth is, the reason why I'm still loving, and to everyone who's everywhere, all my exes, the one that thinks that they're now, they are my Zs. You actually now you are my As. So because I read the Bible and find out who Jesus Christ is, because I'm a born-again Christian, and I always teach myself when I'm always as well teaching or preaching my fellow. God is everything. Trust me.
Sweet baby Siama, tell us a solution according to the past relationships you've had, a solution that you think women, men out there should change, like something that umsajja chaba ino kuchusa muna gamba. Man.
Yeah, first of all, don't expect a particular outcome when you're going into a relationship. We expect a lot, and then we end up being disappointed. Yeah. So don't go with that expectation of yours. And then another thing, self-love first. Trust me, before someone loves you, you need to love yourself first. Because when you love this person like a lot, you're gonna end up committing suicide. You're gonna end up, you know, doing something to yourself because you feel like you can't live without this person. Yes, and then know your worth, my love. Don't listen to these men what they are telling you. Mbusimani ebye dambu mbuwai. Know your worth. Know your worth. Know your worth. Period.
We should have had some other lady on to the set because. Okay, big man. Tell us some of the issues and the solution that relationships are facing these days, and yeah, what they should be changed, like what should change.
Well, we as this 20th century, we are facing a lot of issues, especially when it comes to committing. Like, don't come into a relationship where you're not ready to commit. Like, if you ain't serious, don't waste people's time. Like, another thing is letting go of your issues in your past relationships. Don't carry your luggage, your bag and garbage to this new thing. Like, okay, you are starting afresh. Don't bring me and tell me Martin's ex song I time pizza what? I'm not your ex. It's okay, yeah?
You're very correct, bro. Yeah, it's true.
So I feel like you guys always bring back issues that you had and reflect them into the new guy. I'll be disturbed. I mean, like, why are you always comparing me with someone you feel like you have let and go? So that makes me start categorizing you, like, oh, maybe you're a 1 month thing. Maybe after fun, we are moving on, you know? And that's it. Like, You don't show me that you are committed. Like, people commit. Like, if you're not committing, don't waste time. Look for, how do you call them? Besties, eh?
Those are mine. I think one thing is people should learn to heal from their previous relationship before jumping into a relationship. You understand? Because if you do not, you're going to find yourself in 5 or 6 different relationships in 5 months.
In 1 week.
Yes,
in a week.
And automatically you're automatically becoming a whore. And you
exactly.
Understand? But you have to allow yourself heal.
Heal.
Take your time. Understand.
Find out.
Break up. is not a mistake, it's an experience.
Exactly.
And if you get that, you know that, okay, yeah, these are the mistakes that I made. Also understand that every breakup is not one-sided.
Exactly.
Both parties made mistakes. You understand? You need to understand that. And when you understand that, I think everything will be well with you, and that's it.
Okay, guys, we have reached the end of the show. For all of you who have been watching and you've actually got something, hope that we have given you something that you've been looking for, sorry, because very many of you women out there, or men, you are stuck in relationships that are not working. You are stuck with someone, you think you love them, but in actual sense, your mind is not. And like she said, self-love. You have to first love yourself before you love someone else, because they will not know how to love you if you do not know how to love yourself. Make sure you stay tuned. Every Sunday, we're going to be here. We're going to be talking about the topics that you do not want to talk about. Boyfriend, what if I tell him now I'm Bogoria?
By the way,
men, there are some men that have this masculinity thing in them that when a woman tries to say something, he shouts. He's first.
That's not a relationship.
Understand that it's not just all men who have that. Sometimes it's the response. As I said, how you put your words as a woman, knowing the place of a woman, how you put your words. You have the right to shout when you want, when you feel like you're oppressed, you understand? Yeah. But there's something that you should say, like, okay, this is this and this is that. And when you say it in a calm way, as a woman, as a queen, queens do not shout. They command respect by not exactly. Shouting. Understand the difference?
Something like being savage and you want to be as
a woman. One more last thing is you guys, you have to know that. That's why I told about the behaviors, everything. Not everyone that is you with is in relationship. Some people are just there for eating, yamping, and others. So you can break up when you can break up with someone who is not broken up. Something you have to know, this thing that you go into is one of the work of God. Marriage.
My G there said communication.
Marriage. Ask. Don't just love. You have to go with an intention, expecting yourself to go to marriage, not to just I love you, I love you too. That's just it's bored. So that's why when I get someone, I have to say, are we moving in? Marriage, work of God, so that we get blessings. Yeah. So if you dare, like, I want my man to be taking me out. Yes, they can take you out, but build him, build yourself,
yeah,
build a family. Because it's a work of God. We go back to God.
Okay, guys, we have reached the end of the show. We shall bring back these guests at a point in another episode, because we have still left some things unspoken of, but because of time, we have to go and do other things. But stay tuned. Every Sunday, we're always here from 8 p.m. to 9 p.m., giving you nothing but hot topics. So make sure you're tuned in with your girl, Samara. He's aka Wild and Free. Also, don't forget to go down to our social media platforms, that is ABBA Television Uganda, and give us an opinion of what you thought and the lesson you have learned. I hope this helps those who are out there. Stay tuned. See you next time.